Hello everyone, my name is Shani Hu, Sangfor HCI Senior Product Manager. In this video, I'm going to give you a brief introduction to our CDP technology on HCI. CDP stands for Continuous Data Protection, and this feature came out with the version 5.8.3. As we know, on Sangfor HCI, we have free of charge backup feature integrated. With backup, customers can choose to use it to protect their VM's data. However, the minimum backup interval is 1 hour. That means if you use backup to protect your most mission-critical applications, you could suffer up to 1 hour of data loss if anything bad happens to your cluster. That is why CDP comes into play. So with CDP, continuous data protection, we can provide you a zero data loss protection to the most business critical applications running on HCI. Here, I've drawn a cluster of three nodes with our ASV, ANET, and ASAN in node activated. Let's say I have a most business critical application running on the VM1 here on node 3. So if I enable CDP for this VM, the system will pre-allocate 2 GB of RAM for that VM to cache the I/O log buffer of that VM. So as we know, that VM is created by our KVM-based hypervisor. It is actually a QEMU, quick emulator, process that is simulating all the resources you have on the servers and then provision those resources, virtual resources, to your VM. The VM is also composed of a kcal2, which is our file image file. If I enable CDP for that VM, of course, like I said, there is an I/O buffer that is, you know, maximum 2 GB, and there is a CDP worker. This CDP worker is like the brain of your CDP. When you assign a CDP policy to that VM, the policy will be initiated by the CDP worker, and the worker will distribute all the workloads, all the CDP processes within the system. And our CDP is leveraging the backup as well. So the process is like this. The QEMU and the kcal2 make up of your VM. And when the CDP is activated, first, the system will initiate a full backup of the kcal2. So there will be a full backup. Let's say this is called a backup point on our CDP. We call it BP1. This is a full backup. It's a full copy of your kcal2 file. And then subsequently, like we can have incremental backup. This is BP2, is an incremental backup. And then we can have BP3, which is also an incremental backup. Only data is changed or data is added will be backed up to that repository. So how is CDP working with our backup? It works like this. After the backup is initialized, every 1 second or 5 seconds, customer can choose, you know, to synchronize the I/O to the I/O cache. And then the CDP worker will copy that I/O logs to the CDP repository. Okay, it will put a timestamp to the I/O log and then distribute it between the backup points. So between the backup points, let's say if I, you know, enable a hourly backup in the CDP policy, that means maybe here is 2 o'clock, at this point of time is 3 o'clock, here is 4 o'clock, between this 1 hour, the CDP worker will distribute all those IOs if I, you know, configure the CDP policy to be, you know, 1 second, then there will be an RP recovery point, which is the point of time where the I/O is happening. There could be RP1, RP2, RP3, and you know, within this 1 hour interval, there could be 3,600 recovery points created. That means every 1 second, your I/O will be cached to the I/O, to the I/O buffer, and then the CDP worker will distribute that I/O and display it on the user interface as a recovery point. So I could have all the recovery points in between the backup points to form your CDP repository. So basically, you know, in the CDP repository, I have my backup file, I have my I/O logs, which is displayed as a recovery point on the user interface. If I need to recover my data, what I need to do is basically, let's say here, the RP3, I want to recover the data from that point of time. Then all the recovery points in front of RP3, RP1 and RP2, together with BP1, they will be merged and then present a usable file to your management console, and then you can recover the file or recover the virtual machine based on your requirements. And like I said, the CDP worker is the brain of our CDP strategy, and this CDP worker is commanded by the web UI. We have a very intuitive web UI, so customers can create a CDP policy, and after that CDP policy is activated, the CDP worker will become in effect, and then it will distribute all the IOs based on your policy, based on your CDP policy. So basically all the features on HCI is policy-based management. You create a policy, and after the policy is initiated, everything will be done on the background automatically. So there are a couple of benefits brought by CDP when you have it enabled on HCI. First, it can provide you an ultimate data protection for your most business critical applications. Basically, with CDP enabled, you will suffer no data loss. Okay, the RPO is near zero. Especially when you apply this 1 second I/O log recording interval in the CDP policy. So that is the, you know, most advanced data protection technology we've ever seen on the market. The second benefit is that this CDP is deeply integrated into the kernel of our platform. It doesn't involve any third-party software, so it's very easy to operate and simplified, simple in architecture, and also easy to use. There's no need for any third-party involvement. Everything is integrated one-stop CDP technology for the VMs running on HCI. But also there are some caveats we'd like to inform you if you want to apply CDP to your VMs. First is, because CDP is leveraging both backup and I/O log caching, so to avoid the collision between the two files, we recommend you to separate the repository for the CDP I/O log and backup files. So usually when you do backup or CDP, we will recommend you to deploy an external storage. This could be an external SAN storage or external NAS storage. They could be legacy storage. So once the storage is attached to the HCI, you can put your backup files, all those backup points, you know, the backup files can be put here. And for the CDP I/O logs, it's better to put it on HCI. So you have the ASAN, you know, you can store your I/O logs on the ASAN to separate the repository for the two different files. In that way, the performance of your CDP will not be impacted. And also, if the CDP module, let's say the CDP worker, fails to work, it will retry in every 5 minutes to resume the work without any human interruption. And also, if you are using external storage for the backup, then we do not recommend you to easily switch the storage. Otherwise, you have to do a full backup all over again. It will take a longer time to complete that process. So in a conclusion, with CDP, we're offering customers a more advanced data protection mechanism and feature to protect their most business critical applications. It is very easy to use, it is integrated and simplified in architecture without any third-party involvement. So that's the introduction to CDP. If you want to know more about HCI and CDP, please visit our website, our official website. Thank you.